एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रयाग पटेल, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन आईटीआईसीटी डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. नाउ इन टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ द जनरेटिंग फंक्शन. सो इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द डेफिनेशन एंड एग्जांपल ऑफ द जनरेटिंग फंक्शन. इट इज कॉल्ड द कैलकुलेशनल टेक्निक्स. नाउ हियर फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज द जनरेटिंग फंक्शन, डेफिनेशन ऑफ द जनरेटिंग फंक्शन. लेट a0, a1, a2 be a sequence of real numbers. Then the function f of x equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x plus a3x cube, like this. So here a0, a1, a2, a3 all are considered as a sequence of the real numbers. Now common equation for the f of x equal to sigma I equal to 0 to infinity ai into x raised to I. So ai means a0, a1, a2, and xi means x raised to 0, x raised to 1, x raised to 2, up to the x raised to infinity. So this is called the generating function for the given sequence. So this generating function for the sequence a0, a1, a2, like this. So this is a common definition of the generating function. Now understand the generating function using some examples. So some conditions are there. For example, number 1, for any n belongs to z plus 1 plus x raised to n is equal to nc0 plus nc1 into x plus nc2 into x square up to the ncn into x raised to n. So 1 plus x raised to n is the generating function for the sequence nc0, nc1, nc2 up to the ncn up to 0, 0, 0. Now here our aim is generating function for which sequence. So here first is x raised to 0, second term is x raised to 1, then x raised to 2, then x raised to 3 up to the x raised to n. Then coefficient with the x raised to n as a nc0, nc1, nc2 up to the ncn. So these all are be considered as a a0, a1, a2, a3 up to an. That means nc0, nc1, nc2 up to the ncn generating function for this particular sequence. So 1 plus x raised to n is a generating function for the sequence nc0, nc1, nc2 up to the ncn. Now second example. Here in this example, so many conditions are there. So first condition is, for any n belongs to z plus 1 minus x raised to n plus 1. So what is the sequence for 1 minus x raised to n plus 1 is equal to 1 minus x into 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube up to the x raised to n. Now when we rewrite this equation, then we here consider the 1 minus x in left side. Then 1 minus x raised to n plus 1 divided by 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube up to the x raised to n. Now here 1 plus x plus x square plus x cube up to x raised to n is a one sequence, is a generating function. So 1 minus x raised to n plus 1 divided by 1 minus x is a generating function for the sequence 1 1 1 up to the 1 n plus 1 time we consider the 1 value and remaining all values are 0. So this function is generated for the sequence 1 1 1 up to 1 n plus 1 time, because here in each and every term we consider the a0, a1, a2 up to an is equal to 1. So our coefficient is 1. Now in second example, our second condition is a b. Extending the idea in part a, we find that 1 equal to 1 minus x into 1 plus x square plus x raised to 3 up to the x raised to n. So we consider the 1 minus x as a left side. So 1 divided by 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x square plus x cube, like this. Now in this case, we write that 1 upon 1 minus x is a generating function for the sequence 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Now third part of this second example, with 1 upon 1 minus x is equal to 1 plus x square plus x cube is equal to, commonly we write the sigma I equal to 0 to infinity x raised to I. Now here, taking the derivation for this term, So apply the derivation for both sides. So in left part, d by dx 1 upon 1 minus x. In right part, here we write the this equation that assume 1 upon 1 minus x is equal to 1 minus x raised to minus 1. So d upon dx 1 minus x raised to minus 1 is equal to minus 1 into 1 minus x raised to minus 2 into minus 1. So final answer is 1 upon 1 minus x square. So 1 d upon dx 1 plus x square up to the x raised to n. So answer is equal to 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube like this when we solve this derivation. Then our answer is we can write the 1 upon 1 minus x square is equal to 1 plus 2x plus 3x square plus 4x cube like this. In generating function for the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. So 1 upon 1 minus x square is a generating function for the sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like this. Now here x upon 1 minus x square is equal to 0 plus 1x plus 2x square plus 3x cube plus 4x raised to 4. That means this second generating function x upon 1 minus x raised to 2 is a generating function for the sequence 0, 1, 2, 3. That means if our sequence is 1, 2, 3, 4, then generating function is 1 upon 1 minus x square. And if the sequence is 0, 1, 2, 3, starting point is 0, then generating function is x divided by 1 minus x square. So this is our third part C. Now for part D, continue from the part C. D upon dx, x 1 minus x square. We apply the derivation here. And we will get the x plus 1 divided by 1 minus x cube is equal to 1 plus 2 square x plus 3 square x square plus 4 square x raised to 3 like this. So we can say that the x plus 1 divided by 1 minus x cube is a generating function for the sequence 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, 4 square like this. Now, if we consider the sequence as a 0 square, 1 square, 2 square, then what is the generating function? So for that, generating function is x into x plus 1 divided by 1 minus x raised to 3. For the sequence, 0 square, 1 square, 2 square, 3 square, like this. Now next part is a part E of this example. Now let us take one more look at the result in the part B, C and D. And here we consider the f0 x equal to 1 upon 1 minus x. So sequence is 1 plus x square plus x cube. Now next one is a f1 x, x d by dx f0 x. So here f0 x means 1 upon 1 minus x. Now we apply the condition here x into f0 x with the derivation. So result is x divided by 1 minus x square. So sequence is 0 plus x plus 2x square plus 3x square. Now f2x equal to x into d by dx f1x. So result is x square plus x divided by 1 minus x cube is equal to sequence 0 square 1 square x plus 2 square x square plus 3 square x cube like this. Now apply this thing for the next time, then we get the f3x. So f3x equal to x d by dx f2x is equal to x cube plus 4x square plus x divided by 1 minus x raised to 4. So sequence is 0 cube plus 1 cube x plus 2 cube x square plus 3 cube x cube like this. Now next is f4x is equal to x into d by dx f3x. So result is x raised to 4 plus 11x cube plus 11x square plus x divided by 1 minus x raised to 5. So result or sequence is 0 raised to 4 plus 1 raised to 4x plus 2 raised to 4x square plus 3 raised to 4x cube like this. So in this all the cases we consider the sequence like for the f4. Sequence is 0 raised to 4, 1 raised to 4, 2 raised to 4, 3 raised to 4, 4 raised to 4 like this. So this is the example number 2. Now common formula according to this way is we can write the for each n belongs to z plus the binomial theorem tell us that 1 plus x raised to n equal to nc0 plus nc1x plus nc2x square plus ncn x raised to n. This is a formula for the binomial theorem. Now according to that, We want to extend this idea to for the two cases. So here first case is n less than 0 and second condition is n is not necessarily an integer. So according to this condition, with n r belongs to z plus and n greater or equal to r greater than 0, ncr equal to n factorial divided by r factorial into n minus r factorial. So here we solve this equation, then we will get the n, n minus 1, n minus 2 up to the n minus r plus 1 divided by r factorial. If n belongs to r, we use n, n minus 1, n minus 2 up to the n minus r plus 1 divided by r factorial. So this is a common formula for that. Now as the define of the ncr, then for example if n belongs to z plus, we have the minus ncr equal to minus n, minus n, minus 1, minus n, minus 2 up to the minus n minus r plus 1 divided by r factorial. So here we write the in place of n as a minus n. So next step is minus 1 raised to r n into n plus 1 into n plus 2 up to the n plus r minus 1 divided by r factorial. When we solve this equation, and we will get minus 1 raised to r n plus r minus 1 c r. So finally for the each real number n, we define the n c 0 is equal to 1. So this is a common formula for them. Now understand the next example, example number 3. For n belongs to z plus, we have a series as a 1 plus x raised to n. So here Maclaurin series expansion for the 1 plus x raised to minus n is given by 1 plus x raised to minus n is equal to 1 plus minus n x plus minus n minus 1 x square divided by 2 factorial. Next one is a minus n, minus n, minus 1, minus n, minus 2, x cube divided by 3 factorial, like this. So commonly we write the 1 plus sigma r equal to 1 to infinity minus n, minus n, minus 1, minus n, minus 2 up to the minus n minus r plus 1 divided by r factorial into x raised to r. So we rewrite this statement as a sigma r equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to r n plus r minus 1 c r x raised to r. So according to this, we can write that 1 plus x raised to minus n is equal to minus n c 0 plus minus n c 1 x plus minus n c 2 x square. So commonly we write the sigma r equal to 0 to infinity minus n c r into x raised to r for the 1 plus x raised to minus n. So this is a common form for this example. Now next is a example number 4. In example number 4, find the coefficient of x raised to 5 in term 1 minus 2x raised to minus 7. So here we have a common equation for the 1 minus or 1 plus x raised to minus n, like this. So here y consider as a minus 2x, because we want to write the equation in form of 1 plus y. So y equal to minus 2x, use the result in example number 3 to write 1 minus 2x raised to minus 7 is equal to 1 plus y raised to minus 7, because in place of minus 2x we write the y. So is equal to r equal to 0 to infinity minus 7 c r y raised to r is equal to sigma r equal to 0 to infinity minus 7 c r into minus 2x raised to r, because y equal to minus 2x. Now here we want to find the coefficient of x raised to 5. So here in place of r we write the 5, because we want to find the x raised to 5. So r equal to 5. So equation is minus 7 c 5 into minus 2 raised to 5 is equal to minus 1 raised to 5 7 plus 5 minus 1 c 5 into minus 32. So final answer is 1 4 7 8 4. So coefficient of x raised to 5 in 1 minus 2x raised to minus 7 is equal to 1 4 7 8 4. Now last example of this video is example number 5. In how many ways can a police captain distribute the 24 refill cells to 4 police officers so that each officer get at least 3 cells but not more than 8. So here our condition is distributing the cells between the 4 police officers, and total available refill cells is a 24. So here minimum condition is at least 3 cells to each police officer and not more than 8. So our condition is like this: maximum is equal to 8, minimum equal to 3. So we rewrite this equation as a x cube plus x raised to 4 plus x raised to 5 up to the x raised to 8. Now we want to distribute this thing 4 times, because first as a C1 police officer, C2, C3 and C4. So our total term is 4 term. So C1 into C2 into C3 into C4. Now all these C1, C2, C3, C4 consider as a x cube plus x raised to 4 up to the x raised to 8. So we rewrite this statement 4 times, so we can write the function f of x equal to x cube plus x raised to 4 up to the x raised to 8 4 times, that means raised to 4. Now we seek the coefficient of x raised to 24 in this function f of x, because here we want to distribute the 24s. So coefficient of x raised to 24 in this function f of x with x cube plus x raised to 4 up to the x raised to 8 raised to 4 is equal to, here we consider the common factor as a x raised to 12. So x raised to 12 into 1 plus x plus x square up to the x raised to 5 raised to 4. We can rewrite this statement as a x raised to 12 into 1 minus x raised to 6 divided by 1 minus x and whole square raised to 4. Now here answer of this coefficient of x raised to 12 in 1 minus x raised to 6 raised to 4. Now for that, if we solve the 1 minus x raised to minus 4, then our resultant value is like this. First part is a 1 minus 4c1 x raised to 6 plus 4c2 x raised to 12 minus 4c3 x raised to 18 plus x raised to 24. Now second term is minus 4c0 plus minus 4c1 minus x plus minus 4c2 minus x square, like this. Now when we solve or simplify this statement, then we will get 1 minus x raised to minus 4 is equal to minus 4c12 into minus 1 raised to 12 minus 4c1 into minus 4c6 into minus 1 raised to 6 plus 4c2 into minus 4c0. And we solve this equation, then we will get the minus 4c12 into 15c12 minus 4c1 9c6 plus 4c2. Then resultant value is equal to 125. So 125 ways possible for distributing this 24s between the 4 police officers. So in this example we discuss final answer as a 125. So in this lecture we discuss about the what is generating function, what is the definition of generating function and how we can solve the example using the generating function. Thank you for watching this video.